Is your fit at your store right now? Is it functional? What's happening in your store? What's happening in your lip? What's happening in your work? Are they functioning? You're not here. Are they functioning? Not there with them. Are they functioning? If you have to be in your store or be with your team for it to function, you don't have a fit. You're not a cultural leader. You're not a leader at all. You're a babysitter. If you have to be there for them to be functioning the way that your culture, your fit's set up, then you're a babysitter. If you have to be present to have a presence, you're not a leader. A functioning fit means that I've got a presence when I'm not in person. I'm not there, but I'm still there. Is it a fit that can function? Now, it's easy to say that, be preaching, musical iteration, and all that kind of stuff, but what does it mean? How do you get a fit that functions? There's three little things in here. If you've got these three things, if you have these three things, then you actually have a functioning fit. So think about the teams, think about your story. If you got these three things, the fit's functional. One, is there accountability when you're not there? Are they accountable to each other? Are they accountable to goals? Are they accountable to the mission, the purpose, whatever the story is? Are they accountable? Do they feel accountable when you're not there? And I don't mean they feel accountable because you're going to be back at some point. I mean they truly feel accountable to something besides you. That's it. If they feel accountable to something besides you, then your fit is functioning. If they only feel accountable to you, then you don't have a fit. The second little thing is there autonomy? See, the problem is a lot of folks overcreate on this fit thing. That if I'm not there, then things aren't happening right. So I need them to be sort of accountable, so I'm going to be a dictator. So they're going to be so scared that when I'm not there, they're functioning. No, they're not. You know, if they're just scared that you're going to catch something, that's not having a functional fit. That's not being a leader. So it's about being accountable, but it's also about them having autonomy. They have the autonomy to make the decisions that need to be made when you're not there. When you're not there, something comes up that you would normally handle. Are they able, do they feel autonomous? Do they feel like they have the ability and the authority to do things on their own when you're not there? And if they do those things, do they do them in line with how you like to govern the fit of the culture you're trying to create? So if you've got accountability and you've got autonomy, that's two-thirds of what you need to have a functioning team. The last is access. See, some folks have a functioning team, and they think it's awesome, they live in the good. And some folks have a presence when they're not in person, and it's cool, because then they think, well, I don't ever have to be in person. I need to go to a club, you know, lunch, and then it's cool. I'm going to drive around the block all the time. I'm going to drive around the block. No. Do they have access to you? When you're not there, do they have access to you? When you're there, they have access to you. Do they have access to your principles, to your coaching, to your leadership? Do they have access to you? Are you truly open to them? You cannot have a functioning fit unless you're open to them. Is your fit functioning if you have people who have more autonomous, they're accountable to each other or a mission, and they have access to you? You probably have a fit that functions. Number five.